Welcome to Inside the Taubman Approach podcast. I'm your host, Benjamin Harding. This new podcast is an inside look at the power of the Taubman Approach, an approach to working with playing-related problems such as discomfort, tension, pain, and injuries. Through firsthand experiences and discussions with some of the premier teachers of this approach, we'll be sharing how pianists at various stages of learning the piano have benefited and grown through applying the Taubman Approach. Sponsored by the Golandsky Institute. The Golandsky Institute is on a mission to provide cutting-edge instruction to pianists based on the groundbreaking work of Dorothy Taubman. If you're interested in learning more about the Taubman Approach, be sure to check out the show notes of this episode and follow links to sign up for our newsletter, to stay up to date with all that the Institute offers, including their premier subscription service that allows you to take lessons on the Taubman Approach from anywhere. Let's get into today's episode. Deren, Eryilmaz, welcome to Inside the Taubman Approach.
Thank you so much, Benjamin. It's an honor to be
Deren,
here.
Deren, your center based in London in the UK is the only certified Taubman Approach center of its kind in Europe.
Yes.
Can you tell us about what you're doing with this incredible center?
Yes, thank you so much. It's been a very interesting journey, my journey. But let me first talk about my center, then we can go back to the beginning a little bit. It's a nice story. But it's a very adventurous one. But I'm in London right now because originally I'm from Turkey. And the first center in Europe actually was opened in Turkey back in 2014. By me, I opened it in Istanbul. It was a very, very nice, amazing place. And pianists from all over Europe started to fly over. But then there were some terrorist attacks in Turkey around 2015, 16. So, and you know, the area is always a little bit of a, ticking bomb. It's a little bit of a tricky geography.
Yes.
To live. And anyway, Turkey used to be the eastern country, like the most eastern country in Europe.
Right.
Suddenly, it becomes like a dangerous country to travel in on those times, you know.
Yes.
Because of what's going on in the Middle East. And from Golandsky Institute, or where I am certified from, they said that it's difficult for people to travel there. So you should find somewhere, you should move somewhere, Central Europe. And so that, you know, I can keep doing the work that I do. This is why on 2016, I decided to carry the studio to the center to London.
Yeah.
And right now, I am both working with professional pianists and also some very good amateur pianists. Like I have a student who is a pilot, but he is giving solo concerts with orchestras, you know. So London is an amazing place because there are so many amazing musicians and pianists are located in the UK. And I started, of course, with the help of Edna, Bob and the others, I started to train the teachers. And I am trying to prepare them to the training program of the Institute. So what we do, we are doing some little concerts. We are doing some nice gatherings and workshops, international and national workshops. And also, we are trying to spread the word.
Yeah, of this wonderful approach, the Taubman approach.
Yes.
And so how did you come across the Taubman approach? You have an extensive musical background, training in higher education. How did you come across the Taubman approach?
It's a very nice story, actually. All coincidences, you know. So I started music as a prodigy. So I was very young. I don't remember when I learned reading music, because I was very small. My mother was taking my sister to music lessons when I was a baby. And suddenly I started to sing the pieces instead of her, you know. And then, the focus became a little bit more on me, on music. She also plays the guitar and, you know, like she's an architect and everything. But wow. I became the musician. So I was a prodigy, and then I started my conservatory journey at the age of 11. And then from that age, I was trained to become a concert pianist. And then everything was going very well. Suddenly, I was a very short, tiny, let's say not short, but I was a tiny kid, you know? And because of that, I used to have this giant pillow for me to be able to reach the keys. So I carried that pillow with me everywhere I go. And I was the mascot of the school, you know? She's coming, Deren is coming with her pillow, you know? me and my pillow. And then when I was going, like entering the high school, suddenly one summer I grow a little bit more than the other kids, you know. I just, my Gross height, story. You know. Yeah. But, and they said, okay, you are now high enough to reach the keys so that we are taking away your pillow, you know. And I couldn't argue then. I said, okay. And I was proud that I am, you know, now like a normal person. I don't need the pillow anymore. Back then we didn't know the relationship of your torso, length of your torso is different than the relationship with your in total height. So it's when we sit in front of the piano, it's not our height that is the most important thing, but it is our the height of our torso in relation with our upper arm. You know, if it's a long one, then you need to sit higher, like upper arm. If you if your torso is shorter, then, you know, it's all related to each other. I'm sure your listeners know about it.
You might be wondering, hey, how do I sit at the piano? Well, go to GolandskyInstitute.org, and there you can find resources and how to set yourself up for success by sitting at the piano the right way. There are resources there for children, for adults. Let's keep going with today's episode, but be sure to visit GolandskyInstitute.org.
Anyway, so, but back then I didn't know, of course, that. So when they said, okay, you don't need the pillow anymore, I just give up my pillow. And suddenly everything started to feel very difficult. I was quite talented. Everybody is talented, of course, but I was quite proud of my talent and a little bit, you know, maybe too proud. And I didn't want to admit at first that, you know, everything feels difficult. Why it's feeling difficult? I cannot play. And then my teacher back then said, you know what? It happens sometimes with prodigies. They just hit a rock and then, you know, things doesn't go as well as it used to before. So she started to taking me to some other piano teachers who are using isolation and articulation technique. And they started to make, they wanted to make my fingers stronger, you know, and my muscles stronger, and then stretch a little bit more so that you will get all that things, harmful things that most of us faced maybe time to time in our education. Anyway, so that didn't help, of course, and things got worse in the few years. And in high school, I was really like from the prodigy, I became someone who struggles, you know, barely passing the tests and everything and the concerts. And then I decided to find a great teacher. I searched all over the world, let's say. I work with some amazing musicians. And one of them even told me that, I said, am I able to become a pianist? Do you think that I have the ability to become a concert pianist? He said that, yes, you have, but first you need to learn how to practice. So, but also everybody, every great pianist, every great teacher I worked with, had their own thing, you know, and it worked for some of my problems and it didn't work for the others. And everything felt a little bit of, it was a little bit vague. All the answers I get from the difficulties that I am facing, although sometimes they worked, they either didn't stick and stay with me, or some stayed, but I didn't know how I'm doing it. And if I need to teach it, I wouldn't know. Even I asked once a teacher, like, how can you describe it? How can I keep it? He said, I learned this by banging my head to the wall several times, you know. I learned it in a difficult way, years of practice and suffering. At the end, you will get there. Like, to accomplish something, you need to suffer. If your suffering is, you know, long enough, strong enough, then you should be there. I was lucky because I was also a little bit, because everything felt easy when I was growing up in music, the minute it became too difficult and the minute it didn't give me that pleasure anymore, I started to practice less. So while most of my friends got injured, luckily I didn't get injured.
Right.
So it's not... it's not lack of ambition. I cannot say that I was lacking of ambition, but I think in a way, in deep inside, I knew that it cannot be this. Like, it cannot turn into something that is not joyful anymore.
This is a common theme, my friends. You can get your joy back in playing the instrument through the Taubman approach. Let's keep going.
So, to cut this long story short, we have an amazing Turkish pianist, Gülsin Onay, who was one of my teachers growing up. Not at the school, but she was a famous pianist. So she used to give workshops year, like, and whenever I have a chance, I took lessons from her. And she was the first person actually to send me abroad to, you know, work with some of the amazing teachers I work with. She, thanks to her, I started to work with those people. And then I decided to go abroad and work with Michael Davidson, who was in Rotterdam Conservatory, Codarts. And then with him, things become, I don't know what happened, but things become easier and, you know, it was going better. Anyway, I started to work a little bit more, and then I came back to Turkey after I complete my education abroad, and I became the youngest professor in piano department in Bilkent University, in my university. And then I became the coordinator of piano department. And then one day, Gülsin Onay, the pianist, my teacher, let's say, she came very excited. And she said, "You will not believe what I found out." Her husband is a professor of mathematics in Cambridge. And every year they have this symposium on Princeton University. And this year, my teacher also went to join him, you know, there. And she was looking to for a piano to practice. And then she came across with Golandsky Institute Summer Symposium.
Oh, and
she's always very curious. And she was very curious. She listened, and then she introduced herself. And then she had a chance to, you know, talk and work a little bit with Edna. And she was so impressed. She came back to the faculty, music faculty, and she said, "Drop everything and come." And we had a, you know, meeting with the dean and everybody. She gathered
them. She arranged all of that. Yeah.
Yes, mm-hmm. She said, "You know what? Drop everything. I found the most amazing piano wizard in the world." She's of course talking about Edna, and then this amazing approach called Taubman approach. They have all the answers, she said. They have all the answers. I said, and you know what? I'm sure everybody can relate to it a little bit. In our profession, we always work very hard.
Yes.
But there's always a sense of it's not enough, you know, like you work very hard. It's still like, I wish I could do more. I wish I could know more. And when you teach, when you become a teacher, also it becomes quite a challenge, you know, to be able to guide all your students in a right way. And yes, sometimes you have the answer. Sometimes you have success with some, and you get unsuccessful with the others. So, and I was always curious, like, why it's so subjective?
Interesting.
Why it's so subjective? Like, because I remembered the feeling when I was growing up, everything was, it felt quite organic, you know, it felt quite, I don't know, connected when I was playing the piano. I felt really connected. But then I lose that connection, and I try to recreate it a little bit artificially with some rules and some tricks, you know?
Yeah.
Anyway, when she said that, she has all the, we were so excited, of course, and I was given the task to reach out to Edna and ask her if she can come to the university.
Yes,
it is 2008 then, and then I did all the, you know, communications. Then she was very happy. And she accepted. And then she said, but you have to first watch the 10 DVDs to have an idea. Do you know anything about the approach? She said, we have no idea. We are taking the word of, Gülsinona, and she said, it's brilliant. So we are very curious to learn about it. She said, okay, I can come. But we need a little bit of time when I come. It cannot be in 1 day, 2 days. Then we decided to make a week of a visit. Sure. And then she said, get the DVDs. Try to show them to all the students and teachers before I come. And then prepare all your questions. Then I will answer them.
Again, if you want access to those 10 DVDs, go to GolandskyInstitute.org, because there you can find those 10 DVDs. They're really instrumental into creating a foundation of knowledge for us in the Taubman approach. Let's keep going.
Young staff, with the young piano teachers, we divided the workload. It's in a month, in 3 weeks, we watched all the DVDs and we translated some of them to our students.
That's a big job. Yeah.
Yes, but we understand some, and we thought we understand some of it. Some of it we didn't get it well, but it all sounded very logical. But back then, we thought it's just another idea.
Mm-hmm.
We thought it's just another idea of how to play the piano. We didn't realize it's the it's the idea. It sounds a little bit, maybe too strict, but the more you learn about this approach, the more fascinated you get.
Exactly.
Because it's so crystal clear.
Mm-hmm.
It's like black and white. There are no gray areas. Right. It's like if you have a problem, there's a solution. And sometimes you need to understand your limits and the limits of the instrument. So it's all about, it's very scientific. It's
yes.
very logical. But because it's, to understand it, you know quite a bit about how it works. And not just people think it's all about rotation, let's say, or people say it's all about shaping, like a few things that they hear about. And mm-hmm. they said, okay, rotation. No, it doesn't work for me. Of course, it doesn't work for you. It's not, because it's not just rotation. It's not just shape. It's not just in and out. It's not just walking hand. It's everything together. You need to understand all the bits. Then when they come together, they become something bigger. They become something amazing. But, to understand that, it takes a little bit of wisdom and a little bit of lots of patience, but also lots of knowledge.
Yes.
Anyway, we started the journey like this with Edna. So she came to Turkey. I welcomed her. And we were together 7 days, and I translated, of course, her lessons to the kids and to the teachers, and also this is why I had a chance to spend a lot of time with her, and I take her, to see some sightseeing and stuff. We really liked each other, and I was very curious. I wanted to learn more. So we wanted to have her every year like this workshop so that we can, learn. But of course, it never happens as you wish. So something happened with the university, and then they didn't have enough funds and stuff. So it didn't work out. then I decided to just go by myself to travel to New York and just have a few lessons by myself. I went there, I took some lessons from Edna, and I said, oh, it will be so nice to learn this in depth, you know? But to do that, it didn't seem possible then, because I was leading the three departments in the school. And also I had my own students who were very successful and who I was training them quite hard, you know? So I couldn't just abandon them, you know, to leave them. And then also the workload was a lot. So it didn't seem possible then. But I invited Edna for our summer house. I said, Edna, please come to our summer house. Then we can see each other a little bit. And then we swim. And then I can take some lessons from you. It's like, but I really enjoyed her company as well. But I really wanted to learn from her, but I had limited means of time and, you know. Anyway, so just before she came to our summer house, is it the saying that how break loose?
Yes, that is an expression.
My world just collapsed. So it's okay. The worst, sometimes the worst things in life
bring the greatest blessing. Yeah.
Exactly. It became the greatest blessing, yes. I had an amazing marriage, you know. We wanted kids, and it was going very well. We were at the same profession, and we were also at the same faculty, teachers and stuff. And so I was very happy. I think we had the best marriage. Suddenly, we had a conflict with the administration of the university, with the rector, and then I lost my job. And then we decided to move to Istanbul, to another city, to start over, to start our life and family there. Mm-hmm. And then, 1 month after we moved there, my husband left me.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
So, no, it's okay. It's just, of course, I was devastated, you know? I thought I was the best, best, youngest, brilliant professor in the faculty, and I'm leading all the, you know, important roles. You know, I am arranging all the international workshops in the faculty, arranging concerts, and, you know, everything felt amazing. And I felt like I'm so accomplished, and I'm doing what I was born to do and stuff. And I also was playing, I started to perform as a soloist also, but...
sure, absolutely. You're performing.
Yes. Yes. So then Edna came to the summer house, but she came, she saw me, I am devastated. I am trying to smile. We do something together, and I say, oh, please excuse me for a minute. I go, I cry my eyes out. And I come back, and she's of course, she's a bit worried. So my mother doesn't speak English, and Edna doesn't speak Turkish.
Right.
One day, we are having breakfast. I had one of those episodes that I said, excuse me, I will come, and I went inside. And after 5 minutes, or maybe 10 minutes, I came back, and my mother said, you are going to New York. And I said, what? And Edna said, you are going to New York. You are going to New York. And I said, what? I cannot. I lost, you know, my job. I lost everything. And I cannot even, you know, taking care of myself. How can I go to New York? She said, we talk with your mother and we arranged everything. And I said, how is it possible? It's not possible for you to. But somehow, I don't know how, mother to mother or something, they managed to arrange that. So my mother said that we will sell everything that we can. We will sell your car. We will sell our one apartment we have. So one flat we have. We will sell everything we can. And we will support you. And Edna will give you a room in her own house. And you will just take lessons from her three times a week, four times a week, whatever, whenever I can. And then you will also watch her teach,
yeah.
You know?
Amazing.
Maybe 15 hours a week or 20 hours a week.
You will watch. Yeah.
So it will be an intense training. And then Edna said, you will be our first...
master teacher.
Our first teacher in Europe. You will be our first teacher in Europe. And thanks to Therese. Therese is the first one who came from long distance and learned this approach and become certified. And
right.
She was the one who proved that it can be done.
Mm-hmm.
If you can invest your time and effort and, you know, all your means to it, you can, it can be done. So thanks to her also, I was the second person who could do that, and the first in Europe. So,
what
it happened exactly
story.
Like that, and it was amazing. I cannot believe how generous Edna is. Still, you know,
absolutely,
it is very difficult. I don't know if I could do it. You know, to welcome someone to my own house for months. I stayed with her close to 4 months. And then I found another place with a piano. Then I continued there. So it was a very intense training.
Sure.
But at the end, the wonderful thing is that I would never imagined that I could become the pianist and teacher that I am now.
Right.
Even though I'm not injured, even though I was... a professor in a way, one of the best schools in Turkey, you know, even though I thought I was quite accomplished, I always had to search, you know, for answers. I always had to practice a lot to perform. I had to, I was not injured, but I felt limited in a way, you know, limited in a way that I lost that connection that I had before, and I couldn't create it again until I learned this approach in depth. And then
story.
Yeah,
it was terrific.
Yeah, and then it was, of course, it was very it is a you question yourself when you learn this approach. I was 35 years old when this happened. So 35 years is a little bit, you know, you feel like, oh, what am I doing? I was already a good pianist, and I was always like, what am I doing? Just trying to connect myself again from one note to the other, to the instrument that I played for 25 years.
Mm-hmm.
And but then it is so clear every step of the way, you know, it's so clear that as if you don't learn something new, but as if you remember something deep inside you that you already, you know, had. You just forget about it, and then you remember. But to remember that connection, let's say, or to find that connection again, you need that vast amount of knowledge, which is provided by, thanks to Golandsky Institute, but also thanks to Dorothy Taubman.
Yes.
Genius. Like, how could she? I still am amazed how she could, you know, created this system. It's not just do this, do that. It's this, it's a whole system.
That's right.
Of how to play and practice the instrument, and how to perform music, how to create longer, more beautiful lines and sounds. So, and anyway, I'm.
Yeah, that is a wonderful story. Thank you so much for sharing. And I know that our listeners are going to enjoy every moment of this interview, in just hearing the impact that. Yeah. The Taubman approach had on such an amazing pianist yourself. And let me ask you, what do you see as the importance, or let me put it this way. It's so important to go to a teacher who is certified in the Taubman approach, because to your point, it is a method. It is a comprehensive approach to the instrument. It is a foundational approach that enables freedom, enables creativity. And when it's not approached the right way, when this method is not approached in, let's say, the Golandsky Institute way, or a certified, a real professional way, there can be some real dangerous things that are taught, and people can get even more injured. What would you say to folks that are looking for a Taubman approach teacher like yourself in Europe, to say, okay, make sure that they are certified, make sure that they understand this method at a very high level?
Yes. So the reason we don't have, like, we don't have vast numbers of teachers from the institute, you know, in Europe or in a, you know, in general, is that I don't want to say difficult, but it is a like. Imagine you have the Encyclopedia of Britannica,
right?
Okay, and then some people are watching a few, you know, some people are reading a few books or a few chapters from it, and then they get an idea about some of the things, or they have a general idea about some things, but. Let me just share my experience. I started training with Edna at 2012, and I became a certified teacher at 2014. But I was able to do it in 2 years because I did nothing else. And I just, like, gave everything. Like, I did triple times, quadruple times the work that, you know, people normally do in their daily life. So I was really into it. But what I'm saying that, so next year, 2024, is my 10th year as a teacher.
Yes.
So I'm going to be celebrating it with lots of events. But it is only now that I am fully, you know, like, I'm a master teacher, yes, that it is so important to know everything in detail and all the possible, all, we don't have just one way of hitting a rock, let's say. You know, you can hit a rock from all different angles. And then you need to know, as a teacher, as if you want to teach this approach, you need to have the experience and the knowledge of all those possibilities. And it comes not with just hundreds of hours, but maybe thousands of hours of, you know, having a problem, trying to solve that problem with the knowledge that is given us from Dorothy and Edna and the Golandsky Institute. But then you need experience and you need variety of challenges and difficulties to be able to understand and to see the whole picture. If you don't see the whole picture, then, and if you don't know enough, then you might be focusing on just one side of the problem while the other side gets, as you said, bigger or more problematic. Yeah. And then people, the sad thing about, I'm sorry, I'm just jumping from one sentence to the other. Maybe I can rephrase this, you know? Let me rephrase it. So if you don't know, and if you are not trained well, and if you didn't get enough support from your own teacher, you know, who taught you the Taubman approach, if you didn't get enough feedback and enough exposure to all the possible difficulties and challenges and how to solve them, mm-hmm. then you might not be able to solve some of the problems you came across. And unfortunately, in our profession, there is an easy way, an easy road that the teachers take. They say, well, the other students are doing it and you cannot do it. Then it must be something wrong with you, you know? It must be something missing on your abilities, on your talent, or on your intelligence. And this is the most sad thing, actually, but it's also the most wonderful thing. Now that I know Taubman approach, the best thing about Taubman approach, it can solve every problem with everybody. It's not just for some people. It's not just for talented people. It's for anyone who would like to play the piano. They can, and if there's a problem, there's an answer to it. If you don't get proper training, which I think only Golandsky Institute is giving right now.
That's correct. In the whole entire world.
Yes.
Golandsky Institute is the...
And it is a vigorous training. It is, they ask a lot. And when I was in it, I was saying, well, I already, you know, showed them two of my two. Why is the third one? Why do I need to do this? You know, you always rebel inside. You're always thinking, well, it's so much work. Every year you have to go to the symposiums, all the teacher trainings and stuff. And you need to train yourself. You have to be a great pianist yourself. You have to prove them. You have to play. You have to be a really good pianist in order to become one of the Golandsky Institute teachers. So when you are certified, finally, from the Golandsky Institute, it's like a, I don't know, golden... it shows that you had this vigorous training.
Yes.
And you can solve when you have a problem, you can solve. And if you can't, if you are new, let's say we have three levels of teachers. Mm-hmm. There's this instructor, associate, and master. Now I'm the master teacher, but till now, I continue working with Edna. We all do. We all continue to take, you know, lessons from our teachers, no matter how good we get, because it continues. You continue to learn the details, you know. The devil is hiding details, they say. It's like that. So at the end, if you can't solve it, you have a whole institute, a wonderful group of amazing teachers who are ready to support you, and you can always go ask them for feedback, you know. So once, if you want to learn something, you want to learn from the best, and you want to have that kind of a whole institute, you know, behind you, so that you know that you are in good hands. And this is why it's so important to make sure, if you want to learn the approach, there is vast amount of information online, but before you work one on one with a certified teacher, you don't get how amazing it is. You know, you don't understand how wonderful it can be on your technique and your. Let me just say one more thing. I always trusted myself. I always, you know, felt that I am good. You know, I'm okay. I'm good. Sure. But I have never imagined that I could be the teacher I am now, the pianist I say. I could never imagine that I could say I can play anything. I have means to solve it, you know, understand the difficulty. We now are able to see with that knowledge what the problem really is. And when you know what the problem is, then you can solve it. You know, so I in my wildest dreams, I would never imagine that I can say I can play anything and I can teach anyone to play the piano. You know, I can teach. Yeah, so this is amazing. This is, I hope my colleagues could say that also.
Yeah. And day. I think, you know, with your work in the UK, with the Golandsky Institute firmly established in the United States and growing day by day, we're getting the word out about this amazing pianistic approach. We are sounding the call, basically, to say to folks that are interested, be sure to visit the Golandsky Institute website. Deren, we will have your website and your programs in the show notes of this episode. You have an event coming up in 2024 in May that we're going to be sharing with our community here on the podcast, and really promoting it throughout the next several months.
Finally, again, Edna is coming back to London. We welcomed Bob last year before Edna came, of course, but we had this planned actually on 2019, and then COVID happened. So finally, she's coming back on May. So we are very excited.
Yeah, that is going to be an amazing event. And we're going to be promoting it here on the podcast and having so much information about your work in Europe with the Taubman approach. Thank you so much for joining us today.
I just want to say one last thing I forget about.
Sure.
So because people now, thanks to Golandsky Institute, now lots of people are hearing about this approach. And of course they search and then they come across with lots of amazing, maybe, you know, I don't know them in person, but lots of amazing people who worked with Dorothy at one point of their, you know, career. And but they didn't, how can I say? So there are lots of amazing pianists who worked with Dorothy, but there are not many who get the training to become the teacher of it. So lots of people got those gifts, you know, like they worked with Dorothy, they know about this approach, but they don't know how to teach it in a pedagogical way. That is really crucial. I really ask all the listeners to be, you know, to be just careful and make sure that they find the right person.
Yes, and those resources are becoming more and more available on the GolandskyInstitute.org website, where you can find certified teachers, where you can find master teachers, associate teachers, and instructor-level teachers. And, of course, the founders, Bob Durso and Edna Golandsky and Mary Moran and John Bloomfield. You can find these incredible artists there to study this amazing approach. Well, we're just touching the surface here, really, Deren, and we've got to have you back on the podcast. I think sooner rather than later, we'll have you back on the podcast to get really into the details of what is happening in Europe with the Taubman approach under your leadership. So thank you so much again for just being with us on Inside the Taubman Approach.
Thank you so much, Benjamin. It was a pleasure.